What is going on, guys, and welcome back to The Portfolio. Again, I want to thank everybody who is subscribing to the channel, liking the videos, commenting in the comment sections, as well as following me on Instagram. It is greatly appreciated. In this video, I want to talk about the dividends that I got paid. I'm also going to go over my all tab and kind of show you guys total how much I've invested, how much dividends I've gotten, and kind of break that down for you too. But looking at the account value today, we're at $24,078.98. In the last video, we were at $24,326.44. So that is a loss of $247.46. Lost $59.61 on the day. I feel like that could have been a lot worse, honestly. I feel like I looked at it again at one point. We were down $130. So it did recuperate a lot. Personally, I'm a little bit upset that it did because I have a couple of $100 that are going into my Robinhood account tomorrow. It should be available for trading, and given the momentum that the market ended with today, I have a feeling we're going to have a pretty decent day tomorrow, and I didn't want that to happen. Reason being because I'm trying to dollar cost average in some of the better dividend stocks with my Robinhood app, and I don't want to buy them at a peak. For instance, one of them was Walmart. Today, that one was down, I think, 1.3%. Cisco is another one I want to try to buy into, and that one was down today, but I have a feeling it's going to recuperate tomorrow. So, but anyway, that's for another video. Again, I believe in the last video, I said that on the low side, I thought I was going to get about $77.89 in dividends. We did surpass that. I will go ahead and show you guys exactly how much we did. That is not what I wanted to do. So in the bottom of this screen, you can see where it says roundups, recurring, and dividends. We actually made $108.58 in dividends this quarter. So that's pretty good. I definitely thought it would be a little bit less than that. So it was a pleasant surprise when I saw it on the screen. Just for giggles, I kind of want to see how much I've made total in dividends. As you can see, the total invested was $21,140.89. Total gain and loss was $4,764.42. Out of that, dividends that I've gotten paid is $1,195.64. Found money was $1,371, which I'm expecting that to pick up a little bit because I got an email saying I could sign up for like a beta test for the Acorns card. And hopefully that card is everything they're promising it to be. I don't want to be disappointed with it because I am going to be paying for it monthly, but hopefully it'll be beneficial enough to offset that and start depositing more money into the found money. Referrals are $85 and I withdrew $2,000. They also took out their $2 subscription. Again, I'm not going to harp on the subscription fee because people will argue all day long about it's stupid, you're paying for that, you can buy it on Robinhood and do it for free. Yes, that is 100% correct, but I'm also not investing every time I swipe my debit card, and I'm not dollar cost averaging in every single day. On top of that, there is that 5-day turnover in which I have to add money to Robinhood, which I'm not a big fan of, but again, that's for another video. Go ahead and take a look at the performance for the all tab. Again, we're at $4,869.05. Total gain and loss is 22.92%. People will say, and they have said to me, that that is not as much as I should have gained. You also have to consider that this probably isn't as realistic as it's shown. Again, I'm buying stuff daily. I'm buying stocks daily. I'm dollar cost averaging in daily. All that's going to play a part on my gain and loss. Dividends are going to pay a part on my gain and loss. The money I pulled out played a part on my gain and loss. So I feel like it's more up around probably 25 to 30% gain, which again, it's not investing in Bitcoin. I'm not going to get 100% gain overnight and, kind of look at it that way. This is something that it's simple. There's no thought process at all going into it. I swipe my card and I buy stocks. It's super easy. So again, guys, that being said, actually, we're going to take a look at the Acorns later because I haven't looked at this at all today. I still need to add my girlfriend as a beneficiary. So if you haven't done that, you definitely need to do that. I'm just procrastinating with it, which I shouldn't, but I would estimate by next video, she'll be on there. Wow. Okay, we did come up a little bit. So we're still in the negative, 1064, down almost 0.5%. I did put a little bit more money into it. I think I put like $108 that should be still pending, I believe. Yeah. I'm going to start putting a little more into it, you know, chunk by chunk by chunk. I do plan on going ahead and maxing this out this year. Whether I'm going to get to it by November, December, I don't know. I do want to also work on my Robinhood portfolio as well. So, but do note that I am going ahead and investing in this as well. It's not performing terrible. It's not performing as good as I thought it would. But again, I mean, kind of working out some kinks and stuff, and you know, based on my age and everything, they probably got me in a portfolio that I don't necessarily want to be in. I tend to be more aggressive by nature. So, you know, if I could change it, I would put it on aggressive. I'm pretty sure they have me on conservative or moderately aggressive. So I'm not going to see the gains that I would in my Acorns portfolio. But again, it's a retirement-based portfolio, so I'm cool with that. That being said, definitely drop a like, comment if you have any questions, hit me up on Instagram or whatever, and I will catch you guys in the next video.